Hello and welcome. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX, and we're going to look at how to create a stylized day for night shot in Photoshop using optics. I'll show you how to blend multiple color and light filters together with masks to get our end result. And the first thing I want to do before applying this effect is to turn our layer into a smart object. This means that once we've worked with optics for a little bit, if we change our mind any time later on, we can always go back and make adjustments to it. So we'll come up to our filters, go to the Boris Effect Optics, and then choose Optics. Optics will then launch into its own custom UI. And this interface is the same whether you're using Optics in Photoshop or in Lightroom Classic, or using the standalone version of Optics. So just to know what we're looking at, on the left-hand side, we have our effect layers. So this is where we're going to start building up our effects. And these work more or less the same as they do in Photoshop. So in the middle, we have our viewer. And the view controls in this section are going to be a little bit more interesting later on. And down at the bottom, we have the most important things, which of course are our effects. And we have 160 different filters broken up into these categories. So we want to darken this down, make it look a little bit more like nighttime. And I'm going to come into the film lag category and choose film effect. Now the S in film effect stands for Sapphire. So these are filters that come in from Boris FX Sapphire collection, which has been used in countless Hollywood films and high profile TV shows. And as soon as we click on one of these effects, over on the right hand side, we get to see the presets. And we can look through and click through any of these and see what they're going to do. Do any of these actually catch our fancy? Now, the nice thing is we do have thumbnail previews. So we aren't just looking at names, we're going to be looking at what this will actually do to our footage. And we're going to choose the day for night. And we're going to zoom out just a little bit so we can see the whole picture. And I could just press F to take us into full screen. And now we've applied the filter across the entire range of the clip, but we don't have to. We can use optics to mask out which of these areas we want. So in the top left-hand corner, we can isolate the effect to a particular area, something like simple gradients, for example, and or I can just interactively work with that. And you can see the mask pops up in the effect layers. And to get rid of that one, I'll just click on the X. And we can also use something like the Easy Mask. And the Easy Mask is a great way of creating fine selections very quickly and very simply so. If I want to apply this filter to everything except the girl, I'm just going to quickly draw a bit of green around to tell Optics what I want to keep in. So it's going to look at those pixels and it's going to keep those in. If I right click with the same brush, it's going to create a red stroke. And this is going to tell Optics which pixels or which areas I want to be removed from my mask. And we can fill these in or we can leave those blank. I can also just do a bit of a scribble there. And when I'm happy, I'm going to press the create mask or hit the enter button. And what this does is actually process out the effect for me. So we can have a look at the mask here, and you can see it's actually done a pretty good job with only a little bit of work. And we can refine these areas as well, just by adding another few strokes where we need them there. And there. Now we do have other tools at the top of the toolbar. But for something like this, I think we should be able to get some good results without going too deep into it. And there we go. We're just going to process that one out. Come out of the mask view by hitting M again. I will drop the opacity of the strokes. And that's given us a nice separation without too much work. So we can start to layer up different effects as well. So if I add another layer up in the top left-hand corner. And I'll come down to maybe the gradients and choose something like the color gradient. Now, to get that sky looking a little bit darker again, I'll just use my presets on the right-hand side to find something that's looking right for my sky. And just as I could do with the gradient mask, I can interactively pick up these points and choose where I want my gradient to start and end. And we'll take a look at the before and after, looking pretty good. We do actually see our effect hitting the girl, and we don't really want that. So I can recycle my easy mask just by clicking and dragging it up to the next layer. Now, I don't have to use it in exactly the same way, but in this case, it works out perfectly just to mask out the girl again. There's a quick way of seeing a before and after at the top of the viewer, and I can click here and compare with another layer. I can also turn this off again and compare it using a wipe, either horizontally or vertically, using the split compare tool. So I think the girl is actually looking a bit too bright in comparison to how it's meant to be. She's actually meant to be a bit dark. So I'm going to come in and add another one of our effects just to bring that down a little bit. And I'm going to come into color and just drop in a curves. Then I'll come over to my parameter, drop that down a little bit there. And obviously it's affecting the entire image and we only want it to affect the girl. So again, I'll recycle my mask by dragging it up, and we still have complete control over this mask. So I can click on it and invert it. And now it's only affecting the girl. So we get nice fine control very easily, just recycling these masks. Now, one of the things that's actually really fun to use with optics is to use the type of effects that aren't usually available with Photoshop or Lightroom. So that's things like some of our lighting effects or some of the other things in the render category, including lunar or, in this case, night sky to create some stars. And once again, we have a lot of presets to start with. Maybe we'll use Sagittarius as a starting point. But of course, we can always go into the parameters and fine tune things here. And I'll just move that longitude around a little bit there, just to move the stars into place where I want them to be. There we go. And I can also mask things up again using Easy Mask. And this time I will just choose a different area just to take in my sky. We could use other masks, but because we've got fine detail here, Easy Mask is probably the easiest one to be using. And I'll fill things in with my paint bucket and process out that mask. There we go. That's looking pretty good. I like that. And that just isolates the stars where I want them to be. Now, after that, I can still go in and, change things around or add other effects. And I think I'm going to add a lens flare in here. Lens flare is probably one of the most used effects in Sapphire. And it's, probably one of my favorites as well. Again, with lens flare, we have lots of different types of presets to start working with. Whether you want some sort of realistic ones like the Zeiss lenses here, or we can go in and get something a little bit more sci-fi with the Redux anamorphic. Look at that, it's kind of nice. And all of these can be updated and customized using the Flare Designer. But I'm going to start with the Ingenue Easy 2. I really like this type of flare. And I'll just drag this over and make it look as if she's going to be illuminated by the lights of a car that's sat in the road. So we're going to make this quite big. I can scale the widths directly in the viewer as well as moving around the other controls. So there we go. If I just scale this down again, there we go, and bring the whole thing up, and that's looking quite nice. But again, I will recycle that mask. We've only created that mask once, but we've recycled it and used it four times already, and I can just come in and tweak up all the other little effects that I want to. I can even come in and add a little bit of atmosphere and just sort that in there. I can even blur my mask. So if I wanted to create a little bit of sort of light wrap around, I can blur using the controls here and choose whether to blur inwards outwards or centered. And I'm just going to blur it so that the light sort of goes around our model a little bit. I really like that type of effect. One more effect and go into our film stocks. This effect has literally hundreds of presets to choose from. We can break this down into things like categories like black and white films or color films or motion picture films, something faded, if that's what you're after, you know, get a bit more of a vintage look. And all of these can be blended in different ways as well. So just like in the main Photoshop, where we have different blend modes, we have different blend modes on our layers here as well. And we can just knock the opacity down, you know, maybe something around about 50%, because some of these effects can be quite strong. And I'll have a little look and find out what I want, you know, try a few different things. And I can always have a preset selected and then just favorite that by clicking the star. And that means it's one of my new favorites now, and I can filter by favorites and see which one of those I particularly like, see how they stack up against each other. There we go. I can even come into my favorites and maybe just darken it down just by bringing the curves down there. Maybe coming in and adjusting the saturation just a little bit, and maybe even bringing the vignette in. And that's looking pretty good. So when I'm happy with that, I can just hit the cog and that will bring me back into Photoshop with the effects processed out. And it's at this stage, we can do any of the last little things we want to do in Photoshop as well. But if I want to change something within Optics, I can easily do that. All I have to do is just double click on the effect. And because it's a smart filter, it will load Optics back up with all of our filters and masks and settings as they were previously. So I can go into Night Sky. I'll just use the preset Sagittarius again. And then, maybe just tweak that just a single little time. And then take that back into Photoshop. And you'll see that those are updated immediately. This is a completely non-destructive way of working. And you can save those optic setups and use them later on different shots as well. So if you create a look and you have lots of shots, you can either apply that as an action in Photoshop, or you can use the optic standalone to batch process out all of those at a particular size as well. The most interesting thing about optics is that you don't have just a huge number of filters and presets. It's the fact that you can layer those up together really easily, using masking and blend modes, and come up with completely different styles and looks for the same image, making experimentation really fast and easy. So you can come up with lots of different looks and styles of a particular image, choose the one that you actually really like the most, and that means that you can really have fun and experiment without the consequence of being locked in to a certain look too early on. Thanks for watching. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX. To learn more about optics and to download a free trial, then head on over to borisfx.com. You can also find the latest news and information about all the Boris FX products.